Yo, man, the only time I need an introduction is when my man just put me on to your mother. Okay, I'm sorry. That was, like, super aggressive. I'm just irritated because I still don't got an intro after all this time. Look, we rocking with, like, some sunlight right now, so I hope y'all can see me. I know my melanin is a little bit too melanin-y. That makes sense. And I got some new shoes today, and they, like, real, real old. I think they came out, what, 2002? They make them 18 years old. That's an old shoe, bro. That is a really, really old shoe. And like y'all know how I said, if you saw my last video, when you buy a shoe that old, you gotta buy it in used condition because otherwise it's gonna fall apart. Now, let's go ahead. First, let me go ahead and show you. I have bought a lot of shoes this quarantine. Like, this is like where I put my shoes at. This is all of them. And like, first, I don't have like one of those crazy sneaker collections like you see most sneaker YouTubers. Like, I got like maybe 40 or 50 pair altogether. But like, it's all up here. It's all right here, like under the bed is full of sneakers. There's a bunch of sneakers downstairs, but you gotta go downstairs. Like, but let me go ahead and grab them. And oh, I'm gonna just set up right here. Hopefully that's good. Like, none of this is set up for YouTube background, whatever you want to call it. Like, I'm just doing it because, you know, a lot of people think that you need like this crazy setup, you need like this super nice camera, you need all of these things to start and record a YouTube video. Really, all you need is a camera and something to talk about, and that's really it. So like, I'm not about to try to go out of my way to do all of that. I got some sunlight, I got my camera. Right here I have something you probably ain't never seen before, probably because a lot of you probably watching this probably weren't even born by the time this came out, or you're probably just born, or you were probably, I think I was like 4 years old when these dropped, so I know I don't remember these from my childhood. But this is the 2002 release of the UNC Low Retro 6. Now, like I said, a lot of you probably never seen this before, and you can see they're not in the greatest of conditions, I guess I would say. But if you really consider it for a 2002 shoe, an 18-year-old shoe, I consider this to be in really good condition just because not much needs to be done to it. The sole's not falling apart. There's like very, very little separation throughout the shoe, and you know, like, restoring sneakers is kind of what I do, so like, I'm always happy to find a really good deal. I think I paid like $50 for these. Oh, also, this is the first shoe I've ever bought off a GOAT. So I did buy these off a GOAT, $50. They did not come with the original box or anything like that, but you know, whatever, I paid $50 for it. It's gonna be a fun shoe to do a restoration on, which I've also never done a restoration on the channel. So if you guys wanna see that, let me know down below. I'll probably say like, give me 20 likes. If I can get 20 likes before next week, before my next video or whatever, if I can get 20 likes before I drop my next video, I'll do the restoration on this shoe and I'll upload it. But speaking of all the restorations and things, let's finish this video off downstairs where I do all my restorations at. So, like I said, restorations and things is kind of just like what I do. I've spoken about it a couple times before on the channel, and just, oh, let me get this over here. Once again, I'm back. Like I said, restorations is just like something that I do. It's something I do in the past time. I clean sneakers, people pay me to do it and things like that. And it's just something that I really enjoy doing. I don't do it to get rich off of anything or even to get famous. It's just something that I just enjoy doing. Like I said, I've never even done a video to post it. And I got a bunch of sneakers down here that need my help or whatever. So, back to the shoe that I was talking about. Like, they'll need a toe cap to be unyellowed, soles to be unyellowed. It just needs a deep clean, needs a midsole painting. It just all different types. Like, this isn't a big restoration, but if you guys want to see me do a restoration of these, 20 likes. Most YouTubers ask you, like, in the beginning of the video, oh, like, comment, subscribe. If you realize I didn't do that, and I usually don't do that, I honestly forget the majority of the time. But I don't even see like how you could like or subscribe to a channel that early into the video, because like, you don't know if you like it yet. You don't know if you really like me or not. I could be annoying to you right now. But as far as comments go, like, you can comment like 47 times a video, because honestly, y'all put too much thought into that kind of stuff. Y'all think y'all doing so much. It's not that hard of a job. You just hit the button. As far as a comment goes, you can comment whatever you're thinking right now. Like, whatever you're in your head, you're thinking, whatever you would say to me right now if you're standing right by me, comment that. You can comment, yo, my nigga, shut up and talk about the shoes. Show us the shoes or whatever. Cool. I don't care what you say down there. Just comment. You know, the algorithms. I need more people to view these. And that won't happen unless y'all comment and like the video. That's why it's so important. Just to give y'all a little recap on some shoes that we got down here. These right here. Oh, yeah, these right here. These 14s. I think I showed y'all these before. These need a full... The soles need to be glued back on. The soles need to be painted. Midsoles need to be painted. Those, that's a big restoration right there that I need to record. Got the Lightning 4s. These ones do not belong to me. The other ones that did belong to me. These ones don't belong to me. They need a midsole repaint. They need to be re-glued. And look at that. I'm not trash. Like I'm kind of nice. I'll put up a couple pictures or like little videos of things that I've already done. What else we got? I just did these 9s. Unfortunately, these 9s had like a permanent scuff in the patent leather, which I can't do anything about. These Olympic 7s. Now, like I said, something I'm going to keep saying, when you're buying older shoes, be careful because they tend to fall apart quicker than you can think. This is the 2004 release. It comes with the Jordan face box right here. 2004 release, as you can see, this tape all over it because I had to glue it back together. It started out as just this little part right here. I needed to be re-glued, and right here needed to be re-glued a little bit. You peel it back to try to get some glue on it, then it starts slowly, just keeps falling apart. It got to the point to where this shoe is hanging down to like right here, the whole sole, outsole of the shoe. The back tab is falling off. There's nothing I can do about that. That wasn't my fault. It's just an older shoe. The shoes just start to fall apart after so long. So the DMP 14s, these need to be re-glued right here. Oh my, who did that? Who's the devil that did this? Like, oh, but these are bring backable. Not entirely, because like on this one, this is the one that I do one first so that we can have like the before and after, the sex appeal and the clip art, I mean, and the thumbnail. But like, I can't do anything about that. That chunk of the shoe missing that looks like he got, like he took a bite out of. He couldn't get jiggy with it, just took a bite out of it. So if y'all want to see those restorations, go ahead, comment down below, let me know, because I would love to do some more restorations and things like that on the videos. And this is just what I do. This is what I enjoy. But as far as what the video is actually here for, like I said, 20 likes, I'll do the mini restoration of getting these back to life, bringing these all the way back. Look how long they look. Now, these are only a 12 and a half. I know they look mad long, but they're only a 12 and a half. The reason they look so long is because, one, they're a low top. Low tops always look longer. And then, two, it's a white shoe. I don't know why, but just to me, if you ask me, a white shoe, a yellow shoe, like those louder colors, like I guess a white shoe, though. A white shoe always looks a little bit longer, too. And it's just, it looks so just stretched out and long. But when you loosen them up a little bit, this is not the right side. Put a shoe tree in it. So you know, this right here, I love that color right there. That is my color, boy. And I also got another shoe coming in that is also this same exact colorway, but it's a different silhouette. It is another Jordan. It's my favorite Jordan silhouette. If you can guess that shoe down below, comment it, and I will shout you out in the next video. I will shout you out. Like I said, hit me up for 20 likes, and I'll bring y'all this video of me doing the restoration. Otherwise, I'm going to just do it, and you won't see it, which you probably don't care about, but, you know, I'm supposed to try to, like, encourage an engagement between me and the fans and the people who watch. Also, shouts out to the people who actually are subscribed, all like 272 of you. I know that is like a low subscriber amount to the people that you normally watch. Even the person, whoever's video is recommended right under mine, probably has like thousands and thousands and thousands, if not millions, of subscribers. But I do really appreciate those who do comment, like, and subscribe to videos. I do really appreciate you, and I hope you continue to stick it out with me. Until next time, positive energy activates constant elevation. That is peace. No go. Tick.
It's for my niggas in the fourth quarter. Just watching that clock tick. Yeah, he said. At what point do you start seeing bread? Been out hustling for years, shoebox right under my bed.